Hey, I'm Jake, and welcome to a new show called Jake Plays with Electricity! And this will probably be the only episode of Jake Plays with Electricity. Not because I'm going to be electrocuted, even though that would make for good content. Today, what we're doing, everything is pretty much safe, I think. But we're going to be playing with a plasma orb, like one of these. And you've probably seen these before. They were one of my favorite toys when I was a wee boy. Because what they do is very interesting. If you don't have one at home, a physical one, well, good news, here's a website for you. You can interact with it a little bit, but it's not the same because with a real one, we're gonna be doing some fun experiments. So if you do need a real life plasma orb, good news, these that I have right here are from the Curiosity Box. The Curiosity Box, if you don't know, is a, Hannah, hit me. Oh goodness, got some arms, got some strong arms, Hannah. So this is Curiosity Box 10. These come in Curiosity Box 10. The Curiosity Box is a thing that Michael, Kevin, and I, we spend a lot of time on, and it's a quarterly subscription box that we make. Everything in it, besides the book and the game, there's always a book and a game, are designed by us. So I'd highly recommend checking it out. There's a link at the top of the description. You can get a plasma orb that we made in it. And also, it's good for your brain. It's a great way to support Vsauce, but more importantly, it's a great way to support everyone's brains because a portion of the proceeds from the box goes to Alzheimer's research. And so far, we've donated over
$100,000!
That's right, $100,000! Yay! Okay, back to the plasma orb, or as we call it, Ink's plasma orb. So it's turned on. What's happening in here right now? Well, the short answer is that inside this enclosure, this globe or orb, electrons are being sent out through the atoms of gas inside, and this causes the atoms to release photons of light. Now, when we touch the orb with a phalange or a finger, as I'm doing right now, it provides a lower resistance discharge path for the electrons, which means more current flows, and the filament becomes brighter than it was when we weren't touching it. And usually they are filled with a neon gas, but also can have gases like helium, argon, krypton, and xenon. So we have three different colors. This one's purple. This one here has a green color in the gas there, and then we also have one that is blue. Now, the center of the plasma ball is a rather large alternating voltage, typically a few kilovolts oscillating at around 30 kilohertz. And something cool you can do is if you get a speaker, you can place the tip of the speaker up against the orb and actually hear the frequency. And the low density of the gas in the orb makes the electrical discharge significantly more than in our regular atmospheric environment. And these tendrils of plasma, as I call them, spread from the center, a version of a Tesla coil, in a bid to reach Earth. So when you touch the globe, like so, it's getting an enhanced path to Earth, which is why these tendrils are attracted to your hand if you touch the orb. Ooh, look at that, look at it go. Now for the next bit, we're gonna have to turn the lights off. The alternating voltage at the center creates electromagnetic waves, and the tendrils of plasma act as antennae, meaning that the extent of the electromagnetic field surrounding the ball is significantly larger than the orb itself. If we take a fluorescent light and place it near the orb or just touching it, it should light up. And what's happening is the electrons inside are accelerated, and those electrons create an electric current, which causes the bulb to light up. And see if we just have it a little bit, like it's not even touching anymore, but it's still illuminated. Let's try a little bit of a bigger bulb this time. See if this one works. Whoa, there it goes. Look at that. Pretty darn neat. That's pretty cool. And again, we pull it away, it dies. Now, just for fun, let's try this giant one. And look at that. Woo, we did it. Cool. All right, now we can turn the lights back on. For this next one, find an older broken calculator and rip out the screen. I've already done the dirty work and I ripped out the screen, so here it is. And if we place it on the orb, what should happen is the screen should actually start to function again. We'll see lines and maybe some symbols. Let's see what happens. Oh. Oh yeah, look at that. Fun plasma fact. Plasma is the fourth state of matter after liquid, gas, solid, and then, well, plasma. Ooh, actually, one other fun thing is this. Let me grab it real quick. Now, if you put aluminum foil on it, you can actually hear it as well, similar to what you could do with the speakers and the jack, not jack, different jack. Similar to what you can do with the speakers and getting the jack input and putting it up to this and hearing the sound of the frequency. You can't hear the sound of the frequency, but you can hear this, which I think is pretty cool. Hear that? It's like it's sizzling almost. on the aluminum foil. Pretty dang cool. So, good catch, Jack. If you want to get your own plasma orb, you can get it in the latest curiosity box. Again, link down there. Michael, Kevin, and I are very, very proud of this thing. We spent a lot of time on it, like I said, and people seem to really enjoy it, so I hope you do too. And in addition to that, I hope you enjoy being as beautiful and smart and talented as we all know that you are. So keep it up. Wash your face every night, maybe? I don't know, is that what kids do? Yeah. What else? What other words of wisdom should we say? Floss. Floss your teeth.
Answer your
texts
within a few days.
And as always, well, that wasn't a very good throw. Thanks for watching.